Welcome back to Face It TV. I am Daniel DDK Kapadia. We are jumping into the third match today for Group B for the GSL Egamingbets Cup. And we have Dozier and the crew, ex Astana. They're playing another match. This is the third one. I think Dozier has a flight like an hour, so they're like really trying to get this started very quickly. And we have Kenny S's crew, clan-mystik, the Frenchies, hailing all from France. And it's going to be interesting to see how they do. They've been a wrecking face, apparently, tonight. They've been doing really, really well. So they won 6-0 previously. So 16-0 previously, even. Can't win 6-0 in CS, unless you're just dominating them so hard they decide to just leave. I guess it works then. But clan-mystik, the point is that they're doing super well at the moment, and they are looking like the favorites for the group with their performances. So we're just waiting for the guys to just, you know, ready up. And we can kick off the match. Ex Astana, you know, we've seen them on the first two matches. First of all, they lost to Wizards, the Spanish team, and it was kind of weird. I mean, we didn't really see, you know, what we normally see from Ex Astana. Perhaps they are preoccupied, maybe thinking more about Katowice. Maybe it's always really, you know, late for them. I guess they're used to it. But either way, I don't know. It felt like something was up with Ex Astana, you know, because it wasn't just that. I'm not giving credit to Wizards because they did play great and definitely massive credit to them. But we saw Ex Astana losing too many duels. They like to go for a lot of those individual situations, but they were just losing most of them. So it's kind of a strange situation to see that happening repeatedly and then be, you know, the end for them losing 16-10, I believe it was. So, you know, they then did go on to beat GamePub, but that was really close. And so Ex Astana going up against clan-mystik at this point in Group B. It's not looking super good. I mean, they really need to win this match. They really need to get another match win under their belts. But this is going to be the hardest one to actually attain. So these guys are going to be kicking off the pistol very, very soon here. It's on nuke again, guys. I don't know what is happening. But the GSL Egamingbets Cup. It's just, I think we had. How many nukes? We had 3 nukes yesterday and then an Inferno, and of course only nukes today. Maybe we'll end it with an Inferno as well. I don't know if this is scripted or what's happening. Maybe the organizers should just ban nuke. I don't know. I'm actually a fan of nuke, but I do also know when enough is enough. And we've had a lot of nuke, but it's always good to see. To be honest, you can always take a lot from it because it's much easier to see all the trends, for example. Like, this is another thing with practice as well. If you're a team, it can often be much more effective to, like, you know, focus practice is a thing. Like, that is a very important thing. You can say, okay, we're weak on this map. So you practice specific strategies for that map, and then for that week, you only play that map. I mean, and you really get to, like, understand the nuances, because the thing is when you like jump from map to map, because I just played it and so on, which is a common mentality, you don't really learn nearly as much because you don't spend the time to really pick up the details that you otherwise would pick up if you're just grinding one map at a time. Because in CS, these maps are pretty complex. There's a huge quantity of variables at play, so many different angles. But as I blabber on, the game is starting now. All the players are going to be live in this right now. Clan-mystik versus Ex Astana, the third best of one for today for Group B that we are seeing here. And it is a pistol. Ex Astana, they've had a very shaky record on pistols so far today. Let's see if it continues right here on nuke right now. So here we go, Angel making his way with a candy apple Glock, tapping away at Kenny S. Very nice pick off to get right at the start of the round, removing Kenny S, such a troublemaker from the French side. And clan-mystik's GMX, he's not even allowed to use ladders. Angel's like, nope, no ladders for you. And he's going to go down as well. So they move up to player advantage at the moment. And you can see there is a good defense, good setup on ramp. But they don't have enough men here, and the bomb does go down. Look at this from Ex Astana. They have looked at the last games, and they're like, seriously, this is not happening again. And they have stopped. They have stopped clan-mystik from at least taking the pistol round. But clan-mystik should be the most likely team, or at least the strongest team, to really threaten them in the rest of the game. So definitely want to take every edge you can get. So happy are Ex Astana now winning this pistol situation. So I absolutely cannot wait to see how Ex Astana decide to actually play against clan-mystik, the approach that they take, based on what they know of clan-mystik. So that said, just checking the overview here, you can see such strong aggression moving throughout the yard, and it's completely given up by clan-mystik. This is very common to completely give up on yard. It's, of course, they only have pistols as well, and yard is such a great place to take advantage of your long range advantage against the pistols with the rifles and so on. And that is actually the justification you have here for buying the rifles as well. Also with the strength of the pistols as well, sometimes the SMGs just don't cut it. And here you go, actually clan-mystik making a decent enough hold here in the ladder room so far, but the rest of the map is being taken over. Look at this spray from Markolov, almost getting Kenius completely deaded, down to zero health there, through the metallic wall. Action moving on forwards, but it's going to be a 2-on-1 now, so pretty good result overall. The 5-7, very powerful pistol. Kirishima trying to use it to its best right there. Looks at the AK, wants that, but there are the two players. No way, Jose, is he getting that weapon. And he's going to go down, or not, actually. He's going to manage to tap down Dozier. So unbelievable pistol play coming in from clan-mystik, taking down all but one player. Markolov, the last standing man for Ex-Astana. But they do get the round nonetheless and the bomb plant. So Ex-Astana, we can see, you know, money-wise, all right, you know, they can all rebuy. It's fine. They won the round. But that is a bit of a shame that they lost so many men. So right now, clan-mystik, they are still on an eco situation, pulling out a couple CZ-75s and so on. Let's see how they play them. They're playing kind of tight together here. They want quick rotation times to each other. So as soon as they work out where Exxon are going, they can provide help, stay together. Markov going to make his way through CT Red. They're going to cash a few frags here. And should be business as usual. But three players go down as Kenny S makes the steal on a rifle. The Galil, he's going to even get another one. Switches to the AK. Kenny S trying to go huge. Angel going to put a stop to it, though. And it's just hearts left. Angel is in a 1-on-1 at the moment. Does manage to pick up the bomb. Plenty of time left in the round. An entire minute left for Angel to do whatever he needs to do. And Angel is creeping forwards towards the ladder room, which is a good spot to clear. That height advantage is going to allow you to look at a lot of positions, get a really good idea of what's happening on the upper bomb site. He's just going to go for the plant here, it seems. And there it is. And of course, he should have heard some stepping there. That's what he was trying to go for by kind of faking it out with the plant. And here goes Hearts with a pistol. Going to go down. Angel plays it safe and then takes it down. 3-0 there for Ex-Astana, who managed to take it down. So good job from Ex-Astana holding on to their you know, initial pistol round, moving it forwards, getting the anti-ecos, making them successful despite both anti-ecos going down to the wire. What does that tell us? Now we move into the buy round for clan-mystik. So here we go. We're going to see a pretty standard setup, it will appear, from clan-mystik for the defense. Got two upper, two around the ramp, one floater, one dedicated ramp man, and a guy on the garage, which can be no one else than Kenny S. See the flashes and smokes going down there. So we're seeing a situation where, again, both teams put out the feelers, try to get the info. If they can get a quick pick, that's what they're going to go for. And Adren, you can see he's moved into some good positioning here and a bit of pre-fire onto some kind of known positions to stand. I know sometimes it can look kind of confusing for people who are very new to the game, but these players know all the positions their opponent's going to stand in. We get the benefit of the X-ray. Players do not. Angel going to take down Kenny S. So with that position he gained outside, that's going to turn the momentum in this round for Ex-Astana as Angel nails a second player. Clan-mystik, though, able to respond with SF, dropping Angel. So 3-on-2 now. Good control coming in from SF. He's tying the round together for his team. Clan-mystik now go 2-on-2, saving things up. Adren now taking it slower over in the radio room. And here goes Dozier, making his way through the window. They have 20 seconds to get this bomb down. And Adren's with one health. This is very tough. SF gets caught by Adren. SF did an insane job that round, but that's going to allow them to grab the bomb. They've got 12 seconds to go for the plant now. And here we go. Kiyoshima is waiting in the lower bomb site, ready. And here he goes. Adren, 1 point of health. Can he do this? Absolutely not. What a save from clan-mystik in that round. They really really didn't look so good after that initial pick outside. But they managed to make it happen regardless. So mad props to the French team who managed to take their first proper buy round. And that is always very relieving to not get in a situation where you have those repeated losses going into the ecos. That cycle can be very, very painful to endure, but these are veterans of the game, so they have all that experience they need in every situation. Here goes Kenny S back down to secret. Going to find himself a Dren. He's been crawling around there. But Kenny S is going to root him out. And with the M4A4, he's going to root out Angel as well. Over at T-Red. And oh my god, Hearts with the team kill. Great reaction time, but just not an opponent. Oh. And Angel's happy with that. That's very unfortunate. That shows you the tension in this game. And also a lack of communication, successful communication. And he wasn't reading the radar either. Those are two ways in which he could have actually understood where his teammate was, especially as there was a frag there. Not taking a quick glance to the radar. Very interesting there. We can see, you know, what happened to the money. And they're still in a decent position on the money, but you never want the team kills to come into play, of course. Big, big loss on the money when you kill a teammate. Angel, you know, working his positioning around once again through the yard. He is a lone man here, so he really wants to get towards that CT main so his teammates can bust on in. He needs to provide that distraction. They might try to flash him in here, and actually, there is a flash, but I don't think it was from a teammate. And here they go, funneling out of the hut onto the upper bomb site. Kutcher is managing to take down two players, taking full ownership of this bomb site. And Adren there, going to chime in too. It's just down to SF. He's on a 1-on-4. And, you know, looking at the money situation, he really wants to keep this alive. He doesn't want to go for this. He needs to save this weapon. And that is what he's going to attempt to do as we check his position. We're going to be able to see if Exosana might, you know, manage to, you know, find his position and try to force him to drop that weapon. But so far, we're seeing good play from both sides. Exosana executing very well their upper rush. Perhaps clan-mystik need to tighten up there, because they got out of hut way too easily. It was also just a pure push on hut, because they didn't even get their player through CT main to really cause much distraction. He got flashed out of there at the point in which they were rushing, so he wasn't even much of an effect in that round. It was mostly the grenades and the kind of setup the clan-mystik had taken. It wasn't ideal, and that's really what this game is about for the CT side. Get the information to understand what the perfect defensive setup is, rotate into it, and then you have the best chance to win the round. And that is what it's about. And in that round, that just was not the case. So Exosana 4-2. CSF, you know, shooting his way around ramp here, just spamming through the smoke in case Exosana get bold and try to push through that smoke. You can see quite a few players over in that lobby room and the radio. Falling back a little bit now. Markov going to make some noise over at the door as his teammates kind of wrap around the bottom of the map, moving towards the outside. But it doesn't look like they're committed. They're still trying to work out the positions of clan-mystik and how to commit, how to go forward, how to make the call for the committed play. And here you go, Kenny S. Oh, he doesn't quite finish him instantly. Angel does get a chance to fight, but he does get taken down anyway. Look at this position from Adren. Oh, Dozier, that's going to open up Adren's position massively. Adren can go for a massive flank right now. Kiyoshima, though, getting some really key kills over by the hut there, stopping the play on lobby. Great reaction from GMX. Trades come in. Markov is going to even the situation, do even better. Go plus one now. It's a 1-on-1 against SF, who has really proven to us that he's got the mad skills. But here he goes on the retake. Markov trying to find a position here, and SF hasn't yet actually found even a pixel of Markov. He has to go with the guess, and that's what he's doing right now. He's just trying to at least eliminate a few positions. There goes the flash there. That's going to tell Markov exactly where he is. He's going through the hut. Oh, but the flash was covering him very effectively. Here he goes, flashing up. He still has no idea where Markov is. He's going to hit the footsteps. Now he knows, and Markov gets the kill, and that's going to be the round there for Exostana. And even had he got the kill, perhaps he wouldn't even have had the time. But Exosana, they're really playing much better on the T side than they were against the other teams, and that's not what you would expect considering the results, the bashing that clan-mystik have been giving everyone else in the group, and how ex-Astana have been receiving almost a bashing from everyone else in the group. So very strange affair today. And we can see, here we go, three man, little aggression here onto the ramp. Or is it a bit of a stack? Looks like they're not gonna get so aggressive, in fact. And I see some movement outside. Again, you know, standard situation, and this is really a really key kind of concept in every game. You play to your strengths and you play against your opponent's weaknesses. Here, the weakness is the ranges. Their strengths are going to be the close ranges with the pistols. That gives them the best chance to make the kills. And ex-Astana know this. They are abusing that as much as they can, and they're taking long ranges, making the fights, you know, statistically go in their way much more of the time than otherwise it would if they go close quarters. And the Dren going to gun down a couple players at mid range as Kucha, you know, he gets to tap down Kiyoshima there, and that's going to be a really simple, very easy anti-eco from ex-Astana, and also one that anyone can copy, actually. Just get the appropriate grenades out there, make the movement, stay together, and it's just one of those plays, execute, and you're fine, you're good to go. The only problem can come in with the pre-nading from clan-mystik, but we didn't see that. We saw they decided to make a gamble on the ramp in that round. And here goes Hearts, actually. You're going to quickly toss a grenade. Miss, though. Unfortunate, that heavy explosive going to waste. And here we go. Again, the feelers are getting put out by ex-Astana Dragons as they slowly gain more information. Oh, oh, look at this. There's one player over at Secret. Actually, Hearts here has to fall back, though. What can he do with this? Angel actually moving on top of CT main here. And here he goes, dropping the flash there. And there he's going to drop in behind it. And Angel actually in a very good position here now. Not making much in the way of kills. They know Hearts is there, and that's really the problem. Hearts kind of blocks them there. He's still on the stairs as well. He can poke up whenever he wants. So he actually stops them from moving down towards Secret. Here they go for Secret, though. Hearts fell back a little bit too much, and Doja is going to push him back even more. So Doja taking some space there, taking some control of this area, and he's going to keep the challenge going. And Hearts is going to be there still. Great angle from Hearts. Great from Kucha to provide the trade, though. That's very important in this game. G-Mex is going to go down to Angel, and kills happening all over the map, but the effort is combining. It is concentrating now, as we can see on the lower side, as the Dren moves down. Oh, and he catches SF with a grenade in his hands, and that's always a depressing situation. And quick cleanup there from a Dren. Great round from him as we go 7-2 now. So ex-Astana putting the mad hurt on clan-mystik, who in the opportunities that they have so desperately needed to capitalize upon, they have fallen short, and that has resulted now in a momentum switch in a very strong first half from ex-Astana, who've clocked in 7 rounds already on the T half. And you know, looking at the money situation, they're doing pretty well. Two players with 8k, okay, sure, 3 with 1.5, but that's not a huge deal. They got enough drops in there with the combined 16k. It's going to be fine for ex-Astana. And we got this next pistol coming in. And again, here we go. Going for the 5-7 close range. You get that headshot. If it's close enough, it's going to be that insta-kill. Such a great pistol for only 500 bucks. Here they are now charging through the ramp. And look at this position from Kenny S. This is a very common spot as well in these situations. If they don't check that, I'll be surprised. Kiyoshima going to get 2 frags with the CZ-75. And he's looking for another one. He's going for it, and he gets that vote as well. Dropping the bomb single-handedly, decimating the round for ex-Astana. Huge play. Angel's the last one left. And he's now against 2 rifles that have been picked up by Kenny S and Kiyoshima. And so very, very, very bad for ex-Astana after I was bigging them up, hyping them up, telling everyone how much momentum they had. Here they go. They're starting to get shut down. But Angel, he is going to fall there. Huge play from Kiyoshima's CZ-75. If people were not convinced that the CZ-75 is a great pistol, then actions like that really start to provide or create the argument that it really is a good choice over the P250. everything will be situational, and that of course was in a really great range for that those shots. Again, the close quarters. And with the precision from Kiyoshima, it really worked out. So now we're moving into a buy round where Kenny S is going to have that AWP again. You can see him there playing the position at the top of the ladder. And you've got Markloff, you know, he's just causing a hassle here. He's actually going to charge through the door. They might not expect this. Can he gun down two? Only gets one, even though they line up for him. Angel tossing over the grenade. They're going to fall back together now, it seems, onto the bomb. They need to make a coordinated play here. Grabbing that. Marching on with his teammates outside. We can see, look at this setup here from the CTs. They've only got a couple players like that can have easy access outside. They may want to give this up entirely up to Kenny. Yes, with a brilliant flick there. Unbelievable shot from the man, the myth, the legend, Kenny S with the AWP. Kucha making his way down secret as GMX now guns down one more, and Kenny S gets such an easy shot. And that round was just made by Kenny S's initial unbelievable flick. And after that, they just fell like dominoes. That was so huge, really stopped them from really making any ground. And Kenny S, what do you say about the man? But hopefully we get to see more. That's all I'm going to say about that one. So 4-7, clan-mystik are doing a great job here, bringing things back. And we've got another pistol coming in from Exostana. Can they be as good as clan-mystik though? There you go, Kenny S with the USPS is going to grab a frag, and there is the bomb dropped as well. He can communicate that to his teammates. Those are going to take a nade to the side of the head. Kenny S controls things outside, so that bomb is going to go nowhere. There you go. Round is over, just like that. One more for clan-mystik. And we have the buy now coming in for Exostana Dragons, but it seems as if they... Okay, there go the drops. All right. So they got the full buy. They got Dozier on the AWP. Dozier, though, we can check the stats here. Like, not really having much in the way of luck on the fragging at the moment in this game. So Dozier's going to need to find some kind of personal momentum here when it comes to the fragging. Angel missing the jump there. People are getting better and better at that jump. It's very consistent in the top level now. Very consistent. It's very rare you see it messed up. And look how well they know the angles. So the clan-mystik are leaving SF more or less alone. There they have again the floater, who kind of bounces between, you know, ladder room and ramp there. And SF, his job is to provide info. Managed to take down one play. He didn't spot any more though. So, you know, the info is still somewhat shaky from clan-mystik. They don't know exactly what's happening. With deduction, they should be able to work out that it is outside though, if they wanted to make a guess. And now they know. Angel taking down Kenny S. And look at the jumping, the movement from Angel, trying to evade the bullets, the rain of bullets coming in towards him. Kucha getting the trade, moving on around through the garage, trying to catch more players. And that's exactly what he does. Kucha has really been on fire. We've seen so many great plays from him. It's a 2-1-3 at the moment. Clan-mystik, they are down. Play. Look at the tap action. Beautiful stuff from Kiyoshima. Just with a few bullets, equalizing, or doing better than that. Putting it to a 2-1 now. Markloff is the only one left alive. Kiyoshima, he has been having conversations with the late Michael Flatley. And there you go. Markloff puts an end to him. And he's going to get that bomb plant. So here we go. The 1-on-1 situation. Here we go, switching over to Hearts. He's gonna get the frag, beautiful play from him. He is gonna make this 6-7. So we're gonna have a very close half, but you gotta say, did Exostana run away with it too much on the terrorist side? It really comes down to how well clan-mystik kind of play against the defense of Exostana. But we've seen Exostana, you know, the CT side has been the weaker side for them in the previous two matches that we saw, so. It is a huge question. It is a very huge question. So here we go. Got the scar coming in from GMX. Love it. Love that. Absolutely love that. Look at this position from him. Look at this position. Just he only cares about the silo guy. And we got movement coming from the outside again. GMX going to move in position with his scar. Going to spot the players here. Oh, this is a really bad position. Very exposed. And he still gets two players. Dozier and Kucha fall. GMX there. Bit of pre-firing. The scar is so versatile. Look at that. Catches Angel in the back. And GMX turns bad into good. With that terrible positioning, Kenny S. It is just impossible for Kenny S to miss that one. And there you go. clan-mystik take it down. We're moving into the last round of the first half. We are all tied up at 7-7. Which team is going to make this 8-7? I am feeling like clan-mystik are really bringing back the momentum here. And what is this we're seeing? Is that a Negev? Oh dear. Either way, the Scar action coming in from GMX in the last round really, really proved very, very effective. Kucha, though, going to get traded on. And Angel making his way. The upper push is very successful so far. And it's just Kenny S remaining. Kenny S, he's done it before, but he cannot do it this time. 8-7 for Exostana. Going to pick up another round on the terrorist half. Very, very, very important for them to do that. They have a great, great lead. Moving into the more favorable side now. The CT side on the second half. It's going to be interesting to see what clan-mystik have to offer. We haven't seen them today, and on this stream at least, we have not seen them today. And obviously they have so much to offer, but we've seen yesterday, we saw NIP. They took a much more aggressive and structured approach than when we saw Exostana. We can see a lot of, so we have a pause actually, but from Exostana we see a lot of individual play. We don't see a lot of flashing for one another or you know, set roles in particular. We see a lot of individualism coming in. And clan-mystik, we know they have a lot of executional strength, so they can really play any style very effectively. It's just what their read is on the situation. They have to understand, usually it's not going to come easily. They're going to want to say, okay, let's not rely on past information that we know when we've played Asana from the past. Let's go on this game. Let's try some strategies to feel them out. Again, this is what NIP did very well yesterday. They would start the first few rounds off like pretty slow. They would feel out what happens in various spots. We always saw Fifflerin, for example. He was slowly pushing down to secret, really getting to grips with the player that the opposing teams were putting on that position. You know, Freiberg always pushing the radio room. They're always getting a really good feel and information about how, like, the positions that their opponents were taking. And that can be a great way to start a half as a terrorist side, because your terrorist side is all about doing the correct aggression, finding the right vulnerabilities. And you're familiar with how the other team is playing the map, whether they have good rotations from their positions or not, then that can help massively. And we're seeing a really huge push here. Doji was forced to fall all the way back down onto the lower site as clan-mystik take in like, complete control of ramp, and now they're extending that to just the entire map. Doji manages to shove Kenny S out of the lower bomb site, but what good is that going to do if they manage to get the plant on upper? Doji rushes around. He's going to be entering from main, and Kirishima is going to be covering from the back here. Not going to find any action on him just yet, but definitely it's looking great for clan-mystik, who are setting themselves up to win this pistol round. Angel going to go down, and just two from main to deal with. GMX is going to be tapping away at the feet of Kucha and Dozier. I'm afraid, good sir, you are done. Looks like I can see a pause call then. Of course, that was a little mini pause that we experienced. Very quick. It's always nice to see. Generally speaking, the tournament has run very smoothly today and also yesterday. So props to all the players and the admins as well from the GSL Egamingbets Cup crew. Doing a very, very good job making everything run smoothly for us, the production and the viewers. And we can see the buy round coming in. Or rather, the second round buy after the victory there, after the first round. And I love the little tap there. Angel's head kind of exploding in the distance to the Galil of Kenny S as Hearts just holds down the hut. So again, they're just feeling it out, just holding down positions, getting away with what they can get away with. And Dozier now getting pushed back, missing the initial deagle shots. Not much to do now, but just fall to the ground and play dead as they charge on through. Kucha and Adren, last man standing on this pistol round. So, clan-mystik. They can probably have a lot of strong plays all across the map. I don't think there's any one particular strategy that's going to be particularly better or worse. Again, we really have to see what kind of setups we see from Exostana and like how they decide to play the upper site. It depends on how it depends on how vulnerable they are to certain types of strategies. Whether it can be like really effective to go for just hard rushes on the hunt, or whether it can be effective to go for splits or more, you know, slower plays. It's all dependent on that. A lot of teams do like to start it up slow, waiting for the pick, because that makes the decision making a lot easier. And some of the really good teams don't often rely on that kind of mindset. You can see, of course, you know, pistol still for Angel and the rest of his team. Exostana, of course, without much money, and Hart's gonna easily find that frag. Markloff going down in the heart. That's going to open up the upper bomb site for them. But there is another player, as we can see, waiting above. It is a Dren. He's going to drop now with the CZ75 auto. Very well played there. That's exactly how that should go. And, you know, you put the sacrificial player out. He's like a pawn, a sacrificial piece. His purpose is greater than he truly realizes. And did we get another pause? Or it looks like we perhaps got another pause here. 8-9. I hope it doesn't last long, because I don't want Dozier to miss his flight to Katowice. That would be, what a disaster that would be if Dozier missed his flight to Katowice. I hope I'm saying that right, actually. I am not great at pronouncing these things. But it does seem as if there is a pause. So as soon as I get some information about it, I'll let you guys know as well. Of course, I'd never withhold that. It's like, I know what's happening. I'm not going to tell you, though. I'm not going to tell you. But that's fine. So, I mean, clan-mystik, they really did a good job pulling this back, actually. We saw some really good plays on the CT side. As soon as Kenny S got some good positions, we saw him switching back onto, you know, playing kind of ladder room and, you know, heaven kind of area, just ducking into Yard, but not playing like a committed position there. I really like how that enables him to use his AWP in a much more aggressive way, and it's much more dynamic as well. Because often, when you have AWPers on you, as soon as, let's say, they rush ramp, or they get, let's say, a really good setup on ramp or on the upper bomb site, you're kind of locked out as the AWPer there. You're suddenly like in a really terrible position, and you can just find a spot where it's like, well, what do I even do? So, but by having Kenny S in that position that they had him in, he can basically quickly react to upper, he can quickly react to outside, he can quickly react to ramp, and he can basically just take his pick and always be kind of safe if he chooses to be. So that seems really, really nice, because you know when you put him there that he's going to hit his shots, so then it becomes really worthwhile. So that's really amazing when you have a player like that on your team. And if you can use them right, play around them correctly, then you can really have, you know, you're maximizing your resources. This is why, you know, there's all this debate, especially since, you know, Pronax went into Fnatic. I mean, it's kind of the one of the best examples to take. When you have the leader who does give the appropriate jobs, the kind of appropriate play style to the appropriate types of play, you know, appropriate players that you have in your team. Because again, you know, this is also the same thing going on with Fifferin. A lot of people calling him out, saying, you know, why not just put like a star player in, you know, for Fifferin? Why don't you put like, I don't know, Guardian, or throw someone else in there who's really good or something like that? Well, that's not really how the game works. It is based on roles, and some of those roles need to be fulfilled. Like, you need a really good support players. You can even make the comparison with MOBAs, for example. You need good support going on. You need good leadership. You need good star players. But we've seen this example many, many times over. If you put, I mean, this example has been in, you know, pro level basketball as well. Like, if you put an all star team together, they often don't do so well, actually, because you need the chemistry. It's much bigger than that. But hopefully, this game will get started again very soon, or Dozier's certain to miss his flight. Or actually, I guess if it gets delayed too long, I'm sure he's gonna choose the flight over the game here. So I think Katowice is a little bit more important than this. So that will probably end up happening. But as it stands right now, it really is looking great for clan-mystik to qualify. Of course, we had a very rocky start for Exostana. So, but I guess they are more thinking about putting in a solid performance on Katowice. And you know, we had Thorin, who was here commenting on the fact that Exostana, you know, they've had a really long story, and I was asking him, you know, okay, you know, they're still together, and that is very interesting considering the criticism they received and so on and so forth. And he basically said, Katowice, if they do good, they should, you know, of course stick with the team. If they do badly, that should really be the point at which they decide, okay, it's not really working. Because every team does go through the ups and downs. This happens all over the place in professional sports. We see it all the time. I mean, another conversation I was having with him off camera as well was the fact that, like, a lot of players are very emotional. And this is where kind of all these like folds happen with teams. You go into a game and you don't know how to quantify things necessarily if you're kind of new to thinking about the game in that way. So what ends up happening, if you have a good result with a player, you're like, I feel kind of good. Let's kind of keep this player. If you're starting to have bad results, you start looking for something to blame. And it's usually the guy that's at the bottom of the scoreboard. But that guy might be really, really amazing at playing support and he's doing his job well, but something else in the team is not working. So it can be really hard to actually figure out what's going on. And so we might cut to the schedule soon if we can't get some information to just so that, because right now we haven't received information. So what we'll do is we'll cut to the schedule, guys. We'll be back very shortly. As soon as we have information about this match, we'll bring it back to you. So stay tuned for more action here for the GSL Egamingbets Cup here on Face It TV. Okay. All right. Back in the game. Okay, so 3-on-3, and all the weapons going for clan-mystik right now. And that's a very good sign for them, of course. Very poor money situation on the side of Exosana. You know, they're trying to just scrap together a buy. Managed to pick up a Galil on Dozier. Oh, Dozier gets dropped straight away. Adren, though, CZ75 is doing some sick work today, as Kucha now is the last man remaining. I don't believe there's going to be any weapons left for him, though, around this area. Again, we talked about that before. If he could just get a weapon... Oh, there is actually a weapon, a Galil. He might be able to actually do this. Yeah, oh, can't quite get the fast kill, and he's got no health left now. So well played to Kucha for actually leaving the situation in time to survive with the weapon. All right, so Kucha gets himself out of there, and he's going to save the Galil. Let's have a look at things, shall we? Look at the scoreboard, we shall. Okay, so clan-mystik, 10-8. They're going to be right now. Boom, there it is. Look at that, 10-8. And we're going to see a buy now coming in from Exostana. And look at Dozier in the chat. I have 10 minutes, guys, come on. He's freaking out. He is freaking out. They need to win in 10 minutes. I guess perhaps he might just do it with Dozier disconnecting at some point. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. Either way, let's check out this buy round. We've got the ADWP on Kucha at the moment. And he's going to place himself on the ramp. And poor Kenny S. Some kid wants his skins really bad. And here we go. You can see the positions on the map here. So right now, this is the standard kind of, you know, spread the width, spread across the width of the map. Try to see what position you can push a little bit. Might maybe get lucky on a pick. Here goes Angel. He's trying to be a bit aggressive. So Angel, you know, is feeling it right there. But unfortunately, SF made him feel it in quite a different way, putting some bullets in his face. Adren does get a trade. That's beautiful from Adren. He basically did the job he needed to do there. Equalized the player count. Of course, there's still a big advantage there. But look at that. He knows exactly what's up. And now he knows there's a player in vents. Then he knows there's a player outside. Good information for Exostana to make decisions. Look at this. Lining up for Adren. Gets another two. Great four-man coming in from Adren. Making it look like it was just too easy. Good stuff. But you got to speed it up, guys. Dozier, he's got a flight to catch. Here we go, 10-9 now. Exostana holding on very well. Two AWPs, Markolov and Dozier. This will be interesting. This will be very interesting. This is a fragile way to play. That is for sure. Because as soon as clan-mystik gets some good positioning, then things become very dangerous. Because the AWPs are great when you're defending with them, when you have the positions that you're defending. But as soon as you're starting to get aggressive, it can be more difficult, as you have to edge into better position, or you have to edge into positions, constantly checking all the angles. It's much more awkward, it's much more difficult, less mobility, less room for error. You can't fall back as easily. But look at this again, the kind of counter position from Angel, and he doesn't make it work. Gets taken down for no, oh. Unless Adren has found a way to suspend himself in midair, I think we have another pause. It looks like another pause coming in here. So perhaps more DDoS woes here today. More DDoS woes. I have a pen though, so that's great. I'm enjoying that. Pens are pretty good. I mean, we just use PCs these days, keyboards and all that. No one likes pens anymore, but I still do. Either way, 10-9 is the score. I mean, it's still like round for round, basically. It's Exostana would just manage to pull it back. Thing is, though, they did just lose Angel, and I'm checking out the scoreboard right here and looking at the situation. This is a really, really important round for Exostana to win, because if they're able to win this, they can actually force an eco, so they can put a couple rounds together, and they can actually go, you know, get themselves in the lead 11-12-10 or so. And again, that puts them in a much better position, much less pressure. But the thing is, they chose this double AWP strategy, and you know, Mark Loff was over, you know, he was kind of the supporting player at the ramp, actually, and Dozier is also at the ramp as well. So they got two, they both of their AWPs are actually kind of at ramp at the moment. So I don't know if that's the most optimal way to play it, but that's actually how they have ended up right now. And I think it's primarily because they had kind of far back positions, and at the moment, clan-mystik are actually making the push down secret. They just started charging down secret. That's kind of the last thing that was going on. That's why we see Adren kind of suspended in midair there next to the ladder. He's getting ready to drop down to kind of try to stop them as they approach, you know, through secret and try to get themselves down lower. And they are kind of committed to that as well. It seems they're actually quite far down now. But we have the unpause. Oh. Oh dear. We'll see. There we go. We're back. So here you go. They have made their way down the charge down there. Markov and Dozier should be providing some great cover fire with those AWPs from the ramp side. But the problem is they lost the riflers in there. And you can see, actually, oh no, Dozier did get dropped. So Kucha is left. So he is rifling with Markov. But I don't think they like the situation all too much. Kucha and Markov, they're like, yeah, you guys can kind of keep, you can keep control of the, you know, the lower site. We don't really want it that bad. And with the five players still left alive, clan-mystik will get the plant, and it's going to probably be a very slow situation. They should actually rush down the players of Exostana here, and one of the positions, they have five players to actually try to make the discovery of where the hiding Exostana players are. So they should actually be able to find both of them. They have loads of time. They've got five players. And to be honest, Kucha's position is quite obvious, and so is Markov. Those are two very obvious positions. Look at this. Oh, look, great. Great anticipation. Heard the footsteps. Bit of a pre-fire. Perfect timing. They know where he is now, though, but the key is not for all of them to rush him at once. They need someone going to despawn. Oh, well. Here they go. On to Kucha. Kucha. No dice for him. GMX will take him down. So 11-9 there. Markov keeping his AWP alive. And yep, DDoS is certainly killing, I don't know about esports, but definitely having a profound impact on playing online tournaments in Counter-Strike Global Offensive. And again, we're having another pause. 11-9. So this is really tough because Dozier, he does have that flight to catch, as I've mentioned perhaps too many times. So I'm not sure what's going to happen because, okay, Kenny S is getting DDoSed, it seems. So Kenny S is getting DDoSed, and Dozier is the guy that's got to leave. So maybe they're going to be like, well, 4v4? I don't know. 4v4? Could that work? I don't know. But here we go. They're moonwalking to success right now. Back onto their positions. And here they go. Starting again. So 11-9 again. Repeating the score for you guys. As Markov, look at that. Look at this position from Markov. Oh my god. Oh, couldn't switch him quite in time there. But look at that. That is very aggressive play into hut with the AWP. Don't see that often. Markov does go 1-for-1. Not normally something that ever favors the CTs early on, to be honest. CTs have to cover the sites. They need kind of the numbers advantage because clan-mystik can always have the man advantage attacking a site. That's very basic stuff, very basic Counter-Strike here. And Kucha almost making the kill there. A little bit off, but Doji's there to pick up a weapon if he dies. And that's more or less what this is about right now. It's about playing together, keeping, getting value out of the AWP. That's what this is about. And look at this, clan-mystik all bunching up together to try and move into the upper bomb site. Nades in the hands. They are ready for this. They're pumping themselves up. They're doing a little pep talk, and here they go. SF going to drop Adren. Kenny S. Wow, look at that. That was vicious. Vicious efficiency coming in from the French team. Clan-mystik they're making it 12-9 at the moment. They are actually speeding on into the lead at the moment. And the money situation is now pretty terrible for Exostana. Dozier giving some tips. And they're trying to help each other out to prevent that DDoSing. So here we go. There goes the pre-smoke, the standard pre-smoke into the heart from Adren. See the movement coming in from clan-mystik. Let's have a look and see how things are going here. Got, you know, hearts over in lobby. GMX up on the silo. He's going to actually find a player here very soon, edging out. Look, he's looking for the positions. It could come a peek. There it is. There's the peek. And great play from Adren. Gets the kill. And I love the way they set up the cover for each other there. That's very, very well played, those two positions. And of course, there are many ways to play Nuke as well. You don't have to play even anyone necessarily strictly outside like they did, like one in Garage and one up at the dog walk there. But that's what they chose to do. They chose to do that, and they did it with great team play. And that's how it can really work well. And look at this. Kiyoshima waiting patiently for the flank. Going to catch Angel. Moving into a 3-on-4 with Kiyoshima very low. And Markloff going to take a peek outside. So at the moment, clan-mystik, time is running out for them. And they're just two players left. Are they going to go for this? Looks like they're going to try to go for a kill right there. Going to make a move into ramp, at least one of them there. And lots of chat going on here. But Markloff's going to take down the frag onto Kiyoshima. So checking out, the time's going to run out basically, if nothing else. And we can see that Hart's the last man standing there. Oh, we might actually be able to get a cheeky little kill here. Being silent. Oh, he's going to stay alive, keep his AK alive. So clan-mystik going to lose a round there amidst the chaos of the game, of Nuke in this tournament, and also the connection issues that are being experienced. I think, did we just get another pause? Seems like we got another pause. Well, hang in there, guys. We will get to the end of the tournament today. It's always unfortunate because, of course, we have another match coming up after this, which will be Game Pub against clan-mystik. And, of course, that's very problematic because clan-mystik, I mean, they're the ones receiving the DDoSing, actually, at the moment. And so hopefully the issues, you know, they're able to resolve that before next match. I don't know. I mean, I hope so. I hope so. It would be pretty painful to experience this on the next match as well. So either way, we're just going to wait and see, you know, when the unpause actually happens. So give it a minute. If there's no change, if there's no information, then we'll just have to throw it to a very short break and just play it by ear after that. That's the only thing that we can do. So thank you for being patient with all technical issues. I know you guys are really good at understanding that this stuff is not our fault. It's not the player's fault. So there's no one really to blame for this except the obvious ones. So we appreciate your patience a lot. So thanks very much for that. And it looks like nothing's really happening. So we'll go to the schedule very quickly and we'll bring it back to the game as soon as the unpause happens. Thanks, guys. Welcome back, guys, to Vaser TV. We are here. The guys just paused. Apparently, in all of clan-mystik, suddenly we're being DDoSed. So that is the reason why it is taking so long. I'm surprised Doge is still here, but it seems that's the case. 12-10 is the score. Dropping back into this Group B match for the GSL Egamingbets Cup. And Angel's making an aggressive play here into Radio Room. Wow, SF was flashed. Very well played by Angel. Oh, getting maybe a bit greedy, you could say. Extending his stay a bit longer than he should have, but that's very easy to do. Dozier now, he's left alone in the ramp room, dropping down the smoke. And here goes Adren, actually, to catch Kenny S. Kenny's going to miss the AWP shot. And this is actually working out kind of okay for Exostana, despite the fact that they're kind of behind on players. And the upper side, oh, now things are going pretty south at the moment. Kenny S and GMX both chiming in with frags. So it's just Adren left, and Adren, what is he going to be able to do here? Not too much, it seems. So there's Adren making his way in. And there you go. Does get easily discarded by clan-mystik, who go 13-10 now. And you can see all that text scrolling in. And Poor Kiyoshima, he's saying, why only us? And he's got a little crying face after it, because only they're being DDoSed. That is quite shameful, quite sad. But 13-10, so clan-mystik doing really well at this point in time, and we're just waiting to see exactly what is going to be done with the money of Exasana. They could actually decide to put together kind of a half buy here. They do have a Dren with actually purchasing a weapon, so that's kind of indicative of them going for kind of a weak buy with Angel. You know, he hasn't really got much money at all. But just take a quick look at the scoreboard, because we have been having a lot of continuity issues with the DDoSing. We can now see, of course, you know, Dren topping the scoreboard. Of course, you know, seen some amazing plays from him, but Kucha surprisingly on the middle of the scoreboard there. We saw a lot of good stuff from Kucha, made, you know, very key plays from him, despite the fact that he's not actually topping, you know, really doing super well with the frags. But the frags he has made have done a world of good for his team. But clan-mystik, they are really very close at this point to bringing this to a victory for them in Group B, trying to, you know, get that playoff spot. Playoffs will be tomorrow at 6. CET will begin broadcasting, and I should be able to find a co-caster then. Of course, I wasn't alone the entire time. We had Thorin, but Thorin had technical issues as well. I don't think they were DDoS related, but you never know. Thorin does have a lot of haters. He's so outspoken. But Thorin does bring a lot of great insight regardless. But here you go, 13-10. And here goes a Dren through the vents. They are creeping around, kind of suffocating Exasana here on the lower side. So Kenny Esther, look at this position with the AWP. This requires very good reactions. Kiyoshima is going to be able to drop Angel. And now the pressure is on the remaining Exasana players, who are kind of scrambling around to try to figure out what is happening here. Here goes Kenny. Yes, look at this. Who makes a play like that with the AWP when a player is sitting in the vents? Adrian there is looking for the shots. Clan-mystik, they're all around. They're going to be able to take him down. And things are getting increasingly better. GMX wants to try his luck over at main, but he's not really going to get much, and it returns to a 3-on-3 equal situation. But oh, you can always count on Kenny, yes, can't you? You just can. So there you go, he does manage to take the AWP shot there. Event's not really controlled at all at this point. Markloff does want to put the flag for Exasana in the vents there, and that's what he's going to do, moving through onto the bomb site. Going to spot SF, drop him, goes to a 2-on-2. Still Markloff and Dozier left against Kenny S and Kiyoshima trying to defend from the window. Beautiful stuff that gets quite low, but makes the headshot onto Markloff. Very well played there, very low. And Kiyoshima will secure, massively helped to secure that round there for his team. And you can see that, you know, they dropped another player, and we can see a lot more text talking about pauses. And we're so close now though, 14-10. 14-10. I really hope we don't see any more pauses towards the end of this match. That is what I really, really wish. That's what I want for Christmas. That's my early Christmas present. No more pauses for the end of this match. If I don't receive anything else for Christmas, I'll be happy. So, it looks like they are having a good old chat there during the pause, and we will see what actually happens here. Again, you know, it's always painful. It's always painful. Always ends up happening. We had a very smooth day yesterday. And also, again, guys, if you did miss the Counter-Strike Forever event in London, the VODs are actually popping up on our channel, our YouTube channel, Face.com, which you can also look at the content for interviews and so on and so forth. We'll have an interview with Khan popping up in the next couple of weeks. So stay tuned for that. I know a lot of people really love listening to Khan. Khan is a really awesome figure in the Counter-Strike Global Offensive community. It's lucky to have him, actually, because he's, of course, you know, he has that unique insight of being a really, really top-level player who actually decided, okay, going to step outside of that role and just jump into kind of management. And he must provide so much awesome insight. Imagine having Khan standing behind you, you know, behind your team at a LAN. That's got to really help a lot. I asked him a few questions about that in the interview as well. And it looks like Dozier said, I won't go. I want to play. So it looks like he's like, screw it. I'm going to miss my float. I'm probably not paying for it anyway. And yeah, so we'll see what happens, guys. It's looking quite grim at this point in time. So what we should do is we'll throw up the schedule once again, and we'll wait for this game to get started, and we'll bring it back as soon as it's ready so I don't ramble on. Hey, guys, welcome back to Face It TV. We are here to try to conclude this Group B match between clan-mystik and Exasana Dragons. We've just got a stand-in, it seems. What did we know? Nope, they were considering it, but no stand in it seems. So 14-10, that's the score at the moment. Lots of technical issues as far as DDoSing is concerned. We have Dozier, you know, chilling over at the ramp room. Of course, Exasana is a very, very bad situation because you cannot play for an overtime. It is the draw that you'd be playing for. And that is a situation that's looking very realistic at this point because they are going with the pistols. But look at that! Might have just secured a weapon over at the outside here. Adren still got his eyes on the upper sight. And look, indeed, Angel's going to find himself not just an AK, but a red laminate stat track. And my goodness, Kiyoshima, brilliant reactions there. Very, very good stuff. Adren's going to come in, though, to try to get a return, but out goes Hearts of Hut, and that's going to be a frag back onto Adren. And it's a 3-on-4 at this point. Looking very bad for Exasana. They haven't really done anything explosive just yet, and the bomb is down. So, does it to be pretty terrible. But Kucha's coming in from behind. He didn't lose any health, but he has no armor, no head armor. Gonna take down Hearts, puts it to a 2-on-2, and Kucha gets caught in the back. So unfortunate for him. It's Dozier left, who could just do this. Both players, sub 15 health, takes down one, looking for the next. Going for the defuser. He has no time. He needs a kit, but there's just no kits around. Gets the kill. Does he have time? Does he have time? They may have just done it. Here we go. Oh, he's going to go for the run and just take the AWP with him. Can he survive this? No, he cannot. That was so close. Oh, wow. So sad for Exasana now. Oh, my God. All right. Angel's, I think he slept badly. His neck is a little bit misaligned. I think got crooked back into place there. Dozier. Oh, there's a friend. You can see Adren has fixed his woes there. So, okay. A 15-10 situation. Oh, my God, Angel. Angel is having really hard times there. I would not let him do ramp alone if I was... Anyway. Oh, my God, it's so hard to keep composure. What is this angle even? This is a fantastic bug. But here they go, charging into upper bombsite. And SF is just mowing down the Exasana Dragons. And it's looking to be that this could be the round that they close it out on. But the thing is that it's a 3-on-3. There is a health advantage coming in for Exasana. Let's see if they can make this work. Great smoke there onto main. And now they know exactly where Angel is. They know it's a player. And look at that beautiful from Angel there. And they just clean up. It's just too easy. In goes the cleanup squad. Dozier gets a defuse. Angel, Angel, Angel. I've never seen this bug before. I've never seen this before. Will it stay like... Oh my God, it's staying like this. Oh my God, that is painful. I hope to God we don't see some amazing clutch from him just in that POV. That would be so sad. Oh, Angel. And... right now, we have that 15-11 situation. Exasana playing for the draw. Again, this is the GSL Egamingbets Cup. With $2,000 up for grabs, $1,300 of which to the first place. And Kucha, he wants that money bad. He's taking down all the clan-mystik players, rushing through the hut. No weapons or armor on them, and Kucha turns them into a puddle on the floor outside of hut. 15-12 now, we're going into the next round, and we see the buy coming in. So let's see how they deal with this now, clan-mystik. It's like Markov's internet just went down, apparently. So more pauses. More pauses, yes! I love pauses. Pauses are great. So let's see how this actually works. It's always really funny with the delay, and also because, of course, for a player to join, they have to unpause, and so on and so forth. So it can be hard sometimes to actually see what's happening on the server. If there's no communication from the players to the admins, and then from the admins to the production, then it's kind of hard for us to actually sometimes understand what's happening. But from what we saw there, from what the players were saying, is that Markloff's internet went down. I don't know if that is even related to DDoSing. Maybe that's just his internet just went down. But we'll see. It looks like we do have 10 on the server at the very least, and they are readying. So we'll probably go back in the game. Here we go. Okay, so let's try this again, shall we? 15-12, clan-mystik, one more for the win. Axis on the Dragons playing for the draw. There's no overtime in group play. So, clan-mystik, let's check out the overview here and see how they do the split here. They're playing quite standard from the split the players were seeing at the very least. From the beginning of the round, this is, again, to try to get some information. As you can see, we have all those pre-smokes coming in from Exostana. That, of course, really limits... That basically cuts down some time on the round. That is one thing that the smokes are really important to do. Because, of course, the terrorists are much more time-sensitive. They have to get their bomb down. And the counter-terrorists, a big, big way to play that is to create delay. And smokes and flashes, that's one way to really create delay. The other way is to prevent them gaining ground and positioning. So if you really limit them from gaining ground outside and gaining ground on hut and on ramp as well, then they at some point have to make a gamble that can go really badly for them because they don't know exactly what they're going to be walking into. And that's another way for the counter-terrorists to really kind of hurt the terrorists' chances on the round. But Markov, look at this sneaky play coming in, edging his way through Garage, does catch Kenny S there, but he has to deal with one more player, and he's unable to do it. GMX will take him down. So now we have a 4-on-4 again. And looks like they are converging on the upper site here. They got a man in the main. Great move from Matt there. So actually, yeah, they did have a stand-in indeed. So trade's going all around. It's a 1-on-1 now. Dozier, he's got full health. Oh, he saw exactly where Matt was going. Matt's going to go for the extremely fast plant here. But little does he know, actually, he's got a Dozier right on his tail. In fact, Dozier was taking it slow. Didn't hear the plant sound. And we can see that Matt actually went into below Dozier right now, just taking it slow, taking it easy. There he spots Dozier. Dozier spots him, and Dozier is the one to get the kill and the defuse. So Exostana, they go 15 to 13. Two rounds from making the tie happen. And of course, we still need to show one more best of one after this. It's going to be Game Pub against clan-mystik for Group B. And again, if you just joined us, if you're not aware of the current state of what's happening, Group A was yesterday, had some awesome games from NIP, always an absolute joy, an absolute pleasure to watch them play, and they managed to win, I think, every game that they played on Nuke, 16-7, and they played 3 nukes in a row, which was interesting, but much like today, but it means that NIP and Kick are going to be waiting in the playoffs already, having qualified for Group A. And here we go, look at this, clan-mystik. Charging on outside, this looks like a push down through secret. They have the coverage with the smokes going all the way across the yard. And this is very, very readable from Exostana. They should be able to predict this. Dozier's looking for the flank there. We often see with that play that you can get a flanker. And the reason, the way the flanker works in that position that Dozier's trying to watch out for is because when they're all moving down secret, that should, in theory, cause the ramp player to rotate and open up ramp a little bit. And that's how you've got to be careful for that position. We got Adren now. Great spray. Catches two. And Kucha there at the hut looking for some kind of flank coming in. And he's not going to even be able to execute that fight. It's going to be Markov now at the back trying to provide support for Dozier. He's got the AK. And they haven't yet got the bomb down. So this is anyone's round at this point. But look at that. How does he not get a kill on Markov? And finally he will. But Dozier's there with the support. Going to get the round. 15 to 14. One round for the draw. Or one round for clan-mystik to secure the win. Let us see exactly what happens. And if there's a pause now, I'm just gonna eat this pen that I like so much, because that's not gonna be fun. Or at least that'd be more fun than another pause. But regardless, let's check out how clan-mystik want to win this round. Again, it's always on the terrace. It's their prerogative to make the moves, as they need to get that plant down. They are the ones who are pressured by the clock. So you can see the standard set up again. We've got one radio, one, on the door, squeaky, one on outside, just along the width of the map again, trying to see what they can get. The bomb has dropped. And this is really where in-game leaders are very important, because in-game leaders have to pull together all the information that your team basically figures out, and then need to decide what the correct play is, and your team needs to fall in very quickly. And you can have set plays you can run as well off of off of stuff like this. Would you spot a weakness outside or a weakness upper or a weakness ramp? There are set plays you can make off of a kind of a round like this. But we see already Kenny S going for a bit of a pick, edging out, doesn't win the duel. Now clan-mystik, they make the call to go upper, and so far it's going okay, but it's not perfect. Dozier chopping off the head there of GMX, and they're going to take the round, and actually 15-15. So it is a draw, all of that for a draw, and clan-mystik so much looked like they had it, and they had to get a stand-in as well. So, I mean, it's fantastic that they could get the stand-in so we could actually resume play. So props to the stand-in, who was Matt. Not sure if that's his actual name, but props to Matt, who did stand in. So there you go. We have one more match coming up after this. It's going to be Game Pub versus clan-mystik. Hopefully that should go smoothly. Of course, we're really delayed now because of this. Quite behind schedule. Either way, thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned for the next match we have. The last one of Group B. We'll have it coming up right after the break.